Hello, everybody, and welcome to Indie Insights episode 60. My name is Highsight, and it's all good. My bot's totally fine. I totally didn't just fix it just before stream started. All right, so how are you all doing this lovely evening? Tonight we got a really great show lined up, including games like Axel the Penguin, Skyhook, and Dragon Game. Or specifically exactly those games. First off, we're going to be checking out Axel Penguin by Sirisoft, who is in here. Then we'll be checking out the finished version of Skyhook, which has finally been released by Quasi TV, who will be here eventually, who is actually probably streaming right now, really cool guy. He's been streaming his development of this game for quite a while, and it's been a really good time. I also have a new mic, for those who didn't notice yet, so I've been testing it out with the other streams. It all seems like it's been good, and I think it's been, it's going to be a nice little boost. Hopefully you guys like the new sound. This is what you're going to be hearing from here on forth. Whenever it works, and I don't break it. That's kind of the tricky part. But yeah, we're going to go ahead and start right away, because we're running a little late, not very, by checking out Axel the Penguin by Sirisoft. Now, for those who are new to all of this, it's actually going to change for the old people, too, because from here on forth, and I know I said this in the past, but I'm pretty sure I have it down now, I'm going to be putting forward the entirety of the stream on YouTube at the end of the night, instead of just what I've been doing, which is cutting up the games. This whole stream, every little thing that I'm screwing up right here, is going to be going out, except for maybe the intro part, because you guys don't need to hear music for 15 minutes. And it's going to be really exciting. I hope it actually works out, because then you guys are going to get to see this all uncut with my lovely visage, and I think that's the right word. And this lovely new mic is going to help pave the way for that with a little less static sound, I think. So it's going to be a good time. Good time. So, if you guys have anything you want to say while I'm streaming, hopefully I'll be able to respond to you guys a little bit easier. Someday soon I hope to get the entirety of chat in the streams, because a lot of stuff happens in chat, a lot of madness, a lot of good madness. And yeah, let's go ahead and just stop stalling and kick it off. Our first game of the night is Axel the Penguin by Sirisoft, who's actually in here right now. Everybody say hi to Sirisoft. So, this is a loving tribute to all the Sega Master System mascot platformers out there. Specifically, Sonic the Hedgehog is probably the one that comes to mind. This one is entirely driven by Sega Master System. I mean, everything from the aesthetic to the music to the sound design, it's all there, and it's going to be really good. Hello, Gamian. Hello, BP Outlaws. Hello, everybody. BP Outlaws is going to be the creator of our third game of the night. We'll be getting to that soon. So I'm really excited to check this out. Now, one thing I did come to learn is that at least the current version does not use controllers. It cannot use a controller. And that makes me sad on the inside and the outside, because platformers love controllers, and controllers love platformers. They were made for one another. It's beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. So hopefully that'll be something for the future. A little bit of a boost to the platform genre. And yeah, I'm going to go ahead and pause this lovely OC remix music we got going. And let's go ahead and start up Axel the Penguin. Aw, what a cute little intro. Look at him, he looks so determined over there, doesn't he? Look at that, it's the bandana. That's what makes him look determined, is the bandana moving in the background there. So it's a really static image aside from the bandana, which actually kind of gives a striking aesthetic to it, doesn't it? It kind of gives it a little feel of epicness in a weird way. He's the only thing moving. But at the same time, I wouldn't mind seeing some cloud movements or something. Like, you know, kind of make the top of that mountain look a little more ominous, you know? Get a few volcanic clouds and stuff just kind of swirling around it or something like that. I mean, come on, we're in a nice little icy area. We see volcanic clouds. We're going to get the crap scared out of us, at least as Penguin will. So let's go ahead and jump forward. Now, before I start, I do want to say one thing. I don't know why, but this needs to be said. For whatever reason, the button that shifts between full screen and windowed mode is literally the shift button. Just by pressing that, I'm switching between full screen and windowed mode. You guys kind of see it as the black going away, but it's so weird. Why would you do shift? Why shift? Never shift. Shift is for, like, running and stuff. Why would you do shift? Okay, that's just a little controller in this out of the way. So we have a lovely little aesthetic going on right here. Got a little lovely penguin named Axel. Z to jump, X to shoot water balloons. So we started off this looking in like a kind of wintry area, but now we're in kind of spring summertime. It's a jam, you know what I'm saying? It's like hell with penguins, I don't even say that. So we got all these little creatures. I shot at him, but it didn't do anything. Okay, he takes two shots. It'd be nice if there was some kind of a visual indicator that something hurts somebody, even if it doesn't kill them. Ha ha, dead snail. Now, is there any time limits? I don't see a time limit. I'm just gonna go full force. Ah, but I can push things. Wait, no, I can't. Okay, I lied. That was a close jump. Kinda went through him. Oh, ow, oh, okay, one hit kills. That's happened. Oh my goodness, we have three lives. Oh boy. Three hits, you're dead. Wow, talk about brutal. Alright, let's do it. Come on, this is like my jam. I used to play Sega games all the time as a kid. I had a Sega Genesis growing up. This was what I did for like a living for the first, I'd say, 5 years of my gaming career. Now the camera's pretty responsive, but it's also a little too overactive in my opinion. If you look at it really carefully, just the smallest movement activates the parallax scrolling in the background. It actually looks really wavy and almost sickly after a while. You might want to get a little bit of dead space in that camera, so you're only, like right now, if I move to the left, the camera moves to the left. If I move to the right, camera moves to the right. But you can have a nice little bit of dead space in there where nothing really happens, and I think it would actually be to your benefit, because then you can make little movements without moving the entire camera with you. I think it'd be a good way to go. So these guys are unkillable? Unkillable. Just gotta be really careful because one hit sinks the ship. Oh, that was just stupid. Whoops. One hit kill games are pretty rough, and I just noticed you're killing my score every time I die. Look at that, I lost my coins and my score. So basically, you're resetting all progress I make. That's rude. Why would you do that? I don't see why the score has to reset. The coins, okay, maybe, I don't know, maybe that's some collectability to them that I don't fully grasp yet. But you really don't need to reset the score. That's going a little overboard. That's insane. Alright, so I gotta time this right, because if I jump on it wrong, it's dead time for Mr. Penguin. Alright, not gonna try to jump and shoot him this time. Alright. Big jump. Alright. So, can I actually... Good. Didn't know if I could make that. So sushi refills my bubble meter. I jumped a little too high, didn't I? And that was my last life. Game over for Axel. Game over for Axel. I gotta say, it feels super punishing in its current state. The whole one-hit kill system leading you back to the beginning immediately, that's pretty rough. I mean, granted, that's probably what you're going for, is that old aesthetic. But at the very least, try to get me back in the action real quick. Come on, where's the continue button? Even old Sega games gave me continue starting out. And I can't skip this? Okay, there we go. Yeah, you can't skip that. You have to kind of... Look at all that wait time. Look at all that downtime going on right there. That's a lot of waiting to get back in the action. Next time I die, I'm going to actually time that out. I want to see just how long that takes. Now, can I jump on enemies? The thing is, I don't have a lot of room to learn here. Because if I make a mistake, I'm dead. But this is knowledge I need, so let's see if I can jump on enemies. Nope, can't jump on enemies. I was kind of wondering because there's this upper area here, and I didn't know if I could bounce off an enemy to try to get up there. But that doesn't seem to be the case, and there's really not much to tell... Like, as a person who plays games this old, the number one way of killing enemies has always been by jumping on them. Now, granted, you give me some kind of weaponry right here, so that's not the first thing you think, but hey, it is what it is. On the Quasi Raid is here. Welcome, Quasi. Welcome, Quasi TV and all of its viewers. So let's try to not die, because one-hit kills are a thing. Alright, don't touch the spikes, don't touch the snails. Snails and penguins, mortal enemies, till the very end! Jumpy, jumpy. Wow, I should have just landed on it. I was kind of thinking I could be a really cool platformer dude and just kind of bounce over the whole thing, but it seems it was not set up in that way. Unfortunate. Unfortunate. Now, I do like these little animals, but they kind of don't serve a purpose, do they? They're just kind of there for background scenery, I guess. But you also have them in the same foreground area that you have your enemies in. So, the first time I saw that sheep, I was kind of scared because I didn't know if that sheep was friendly or not. Turns out he was. Turns out the next guy wasn't. This sheep is also friendly. But one day I'm going to come across a sheep that wants my blood, and then I'm going to be sad. Platform, platform. Waiting for the platform. Okay, now jump. Ah, I didn't jump quick enough. And that's game over, so let's time it. 1,000. 2,000. 3,000. 4,000. 5,000. 6,000. 7,000, 8,000, 9,000, 10,000, 11,000, 12,000, 13,000, 14,000, 15,000, 16,000, 17,000, 18,000, 19,000, 20,000... Okay, about 20 seconds to get back into the action from a game over. Now, if you thought it was annoying hearing me count that, imagine the gamers who are trying to get back into the action and then find themselves completely locked out by this. That's madness! That's madness! That's far too long to wait. Come on. Come on. What do you think they're gonna do? Like, twiddle their thumbs? I don't need to see the words game over in front of my face for 8 seconds. That's so rough. That's so rough. It's like you're just highlighting my failure by making me sit through that. Don't do that to me. You want to encourage people to play your game, not turn them away. That's the point. You want to get me back in the action as quickly as possible. In fact, I would want, at the very least, the ability to jump past that game over screen. Okay, so I gotta just fall down this one. Alright, there we go. Because, I didn't really see him in time because camera moves quick. And now we go back to the beginning. So far, I find this is just a little overly rough. I understand old school games, that's what a lot of them were like. They were very unforgiving and such. And maybe that's just my fault for looking for something a little newer from older games. But the thing is, old school games had flaws, and we've discovered ways around them. Like, in a game like this, if you wanted to have this easy of a death system, then you need to do two things. Either get rid of lives, so you don't have to sit through game over screens, and if you're going to do that either way, you need to get the respawn time back to normal. You need players to be able to get back up into action really quickly. You can't have much downtime, or they're just going to get frustrated and leave. That's what happens with video games. Players have short attention spans, and there's always the next thing they can move on to. Okay, is that safe? It looks safe. Shoot, 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 shoot! Kill, kill! Kill with bubbles. I mean, at least a few checkpoints would help. So, how about the graphics? The graphics definitely fit a nice... Oh, hello! Touching a key? Wait. Oh, it opened a door. Okay, I thought I, like, teleported there for a second. So, where's this gonna send me? Oh, I think that's an exit portal. Okay. So, the graphics are very nice. They definitely fit that old-school Sega Master System feel. Now, I had a Sega Genesis, as I said before. I did not have a Sega Master System, but I've seen the graphic style, and it seems like they were more along the 8-bit style back then, you know? It was definitely more of an older feel back then. I think it competed with the NES at a certain point. Correct me if I'm wrong, feel free. But, yeah. And the developer agrees that the current difficulty, or the current means to get back into the action is a little rough. Now, move... Oh, come on! How was I supposed to know? I was gonna say, moving platforms. Let's talk a little bit about moving platforms in video games, shall we? Moving platforms in level design exist for one and only one real purpose, and that is to put the player on your schedule, right? It's to put the player in a situation where you dictate when they get to move across something. But the thing is, with the way they're being used right now, a lot of what's happening is I'm just being set into a waiting position, because I tend to come to them, and they tend to be on the other side, and I have to wait for them to come back. Kind of like what happened back there was another scenario where it was a little past where I was, so it went forward, right? I didn't even see it go under the thing originally, but it went forward, and I didn't know that it was going to go under the thing. I thought, like every other platform, it was going to stop where it was and move forward for me. But instead, it tricked me because I didn't get to see it. Now, one thing I'm noticing is everything in the level seems to be happening at all times. There is no sleep waiting on any of the enemies or anything like that until you come onto screen. Now, there's a reason people do that in platformers. Usually, you want your level to be designed around things being seen by the player for the first time and activating when they're seen. But if you guys have noticed through all of my deaths, you might have noticed that some enemies show up in different areas, some platforms show up in different areas when I show up. Like right here, pretty consistently I've had this guy over here based off of my timing, but if I'm a little slower or a little faster, it's going to show up differently. Like this time we're waiting for the platform, last time the platform was ready for us. You really want to have those wait timers in place, so we don't have to... Ah, jeez, I just keep mistiming that. I think I can jump further ahead. But the wait timers exist, so when you first arrive somewhere, it's set up just as the designer originally intended it, so you don't have to worry about things being out of place and things not being doable because you might have missed the right timing for it. So right here, we arrived really quickly, so Mr. Hoppity Hop over there was way ahead, and here we're actually going to arrive a little too early, and we're going to have to wait for the platform. So that's why wait timers tend to exist, why enemies and platforms and everything tend to go to sleep. There we go. They tend to go to sleep whenever the player's not nearby. It's a method to make sure that every time, the player's going to get the same exact experience. And that's actually really important for a good chunk of level design. So definitely something to keep in mind. Now, one thing I noticed about these springs is you don't really have the choice to do a small jump. You can only do the maximum jump. The small jump could really come in handy for certain level elements. Like, you might come to a point where you want to start doing small jumps to get across certain things, but big jumps to get across certain other things. Might be a good way to go in the future. Plus, it would help in that situation, so I can keep an eye on the platform without having to worry about going too high and missing things. All right, so let's try this guy again. I'm not gonna keep going for the coins. I'm a collector, but I'm not that big of a collector. All right, so let's see. Here we go. Back on the games time. Oh, well, I missed that, but that's okay. Now we wait for the next one. I assume there's gonna be a next one, at least. But I don't know if it's gonna go onto the platform, so I have to wait. Good. Good thing I waited, or I would have died. Oh, that's how that's happening. Oh, okay. Well, I'll just wait on that then. So, too many moving platforms in your level can really cause congestion for the player, where they find themselves waiting. It's like a traffic jam in some cases. You're waiting until it clears so you can go on to the next part. And no gamer has ever said, boy, I wish this game had just a little more waiting in it. I feel like I'm spending far too much time in the action. At least not a platformer. Maybe strategy games, but no platformers ever needed that. So I was told explicitly not to go too far to the left here, even though he's following me! Oh, I have a little butterfly friend. Oh my god, nature is so whimsical. I immediately love everything about this game. Have I mentioned this game's adorable as hell? It sticks to a nice color palette, and it has cute little designs, and oh, I love it. I love it so much. And Axel's adorable! Look at this little guy. How can you ever be mad at him? But I come to a scary area now, because I don't really know if there's floor under here. I can assume there's floor here. Oh, wow. I almost died there because of things. So I couldn't hold up or down or anything. It kind of changed the angle, the panning of the camera. Oh boy. What's over here, though? Come on, I know the good stuff's over here. This is the way back. This is where I could have gone. Nice. Some people apparently in chat wish this game had nothing but waiting. I say that they're insane. Too much waiting. I have this lovely game called Paint Drying. Should I just make a paint dry simulator? I feel like I could actually do that. Can I jump over that? I feel like that spring is just going to shoot me right back into the spike. I'm going to go down. Oh, that was close. So another thing you're going to have to keep an eye on is you got to make sure that the player is able to see where they're going. Kind of goes without saying to a degree, but definitely got to make sure that they know what's beneath them. Okay, so that's what that was all about. But then which way do I go? Okay, tree, please have ground under you. Thank you. Oh, nope, not going that way. So which way are we going? Can't destroy those. This one looks different. No? Oh, hello. I missed you. So what happens there if I run out of bubble juice? Am I just stuck? I mean, I guess at that point it's my fault because you just gave me fresh bubble juice. And by bubble juice, I mean sushi. But, nope. Gonna have to wait on that one. And then there's spikes above, so make sure I don't jump. Platforming ho! Well, that worked out. So every level you seem to find the key which opens the door and brings you one step closer to your penguin lover. That is a sentence I never thought I'd... Why did I jump? I keep forgetting I don't have a small jump, I just have the big jump. I got greedy, I saw the coins, and I knew that I wasn't going to get them if I didn't do some kind of a jump, so my first thought was, hey, you know what I should do is jump. That was the wrong thought to have. My greed, it has murdered me. Alright, let's see what's down here. Instant death? Nope. Just a big old pile of coins. So, what's... Oh, those are spikes, but they're hidden. Why would you hide spikes? Why would you do that? Oh, no. Oh, I didn't even see that. Oh, boy. All right, well, let's try one more time. Let's give this one more go. Do I like the game? I do like the game, but I think it's far too punishing. Gamian, one of our Patreon, pushes forward a little bit of feedback for us here, which says, when the game shows you what door the key opens, use the camera transition so the player has a good idea of how to get to the door. Couldn't agree more. It seems like the first time I picked up a key, I teleported there. But that's not the case. I didn't teleport there. I just was looking there. But it was hard to tell because it literally just like, bong, right there. Fortunately, Axel never actually showed up there. So I would agree, it would be a kind of cool idea to actually use the camera to pan over and kind of give you an idea. Just a really, really quick pan over. Like, high speed even. Which would help give you an idea. That's why. That's how I get up here. You shoot the box. Aha! See, I'm learning new things about shooting boxes. Can I actually make it over there? I don't even know. It doesn't look like I'm going to make it. I don't want to die this early in. I'm going to die. Okay. Oh, I made it. Okay. And what's under these boxes? More coins! I was kind of hoping for a warp zone. So I know there are warp zones. I want to see them. I want to go to there. But yeah, camera panning would be pretty slick. Alright, so how do I get to that warp zone? I don't see any breakable boxes. It must be hidden. Alright, jump. Keep the jump up. Whoop. You too. That's right. Getting good at this game. Now how do I get in there? Wait, I have an idea. Oh. And stupidity ho! Ah, look at that. Alright, so there are secrets. I like secrets. Everybody likes secrets. Who doesn't like a good secret? Should I try to get every coin? Well, that's not happening anymore. Because I just got teleported over so far away. The music is very good, and it definitely fits that 8-bit feel. You know, that old almost NES-style feel, even though it's the Sega Master System. I need to invest in a Sega Master System at some point. I need to feel the experience that I totally skipped out on. Probably thankfully, really, but still. I guess I can still get these coins. No, I can't. Well, yes I can, because you left me a way to. Look at you. I think I can survive that, and if I can't, then I'm screwed. Oh, hey, I can actually make it all the way up there. Oh, I'm out of bubble juice. Can I... Ooh. Ah, I should have just jumped to the right. What was I thinking? No, I'm on a quest. I'm going to get every coin in this level. And that will be my accomplishment for the night, getting every coin in this level. Now, admittedly, the gameplay is actually very solid. I haven't touched much on how Axel himself moves. He moves very well. His controls are very tight. It's very easy to know, to plan out exactly what you're going to be doing. There's very little concern for getting it wrong. With the exception of, like, this jump that I thought I couldn't make. But then I could, so it was all good. No, it's all very straightforward. It's pretty easy to pick up on what you're going to be doing and how you're going to go about it. And that's good. That's good for any platformer. You need the most precise controls in a platformer among anything else. Platformers are very demanding. I don't think that got him. Goodbye, Mr. Snail. What I will do is grab this. There we go. Ooh, that was dangerous. Whee! I wonder what Axel sounds like. I wonder if he has a deep, gruff voice or if he's got, like, that high-pitched quack. I mean, he is a penguin. I have a feeling if you took away the bandana, Axel would probably look very, like, not badass, as weird as that sounds like. In the sprite, it's not covering his eyes, but in the portrait that I've seen of Axel, he's got, like, his eyes covered by the bandana. It gives him that kind of, like, down-looking, brooding, I'm a badass look. I do genuinely wonder if he just looked like any other derpy penguin without it. Don't take the... It's the bandana that makes him. Don't ever take the penguin away from the bandana. Or vice versa. Yeah. No. 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 I got so many of these things. There we go. Ah, screw it. Go, go, go. Alright. Now, if I'm just not stupid about it, there we go. I'm gonna get all these. I really want to. I don't know why. I want to know if I just get an extra life at 100 coins. Because if I do, then I'm gonna tell you to stop resetting those coins every time I die. Yep, extra life. Don't keep resetting coins after I die. They're my only means of getting extra lives. What kind of a sadist are you? Oh, you didn't get 100 coins in one life, so you get nothing. You lose. Good day, sir. But I want to win. I'm not even getting all the coins anymore. No. Well, I'm not going to live either, so there's that. Dang it. I need a controller. Alright, no. I got 100 coins. I feel fulfilled in life right now. Now, this is an early alpha version of Axel the Penguin. Currently, the developer is actually working on getting their beta ready. And they are super excited about it. I've seen some footage of what's coming up, and I think it's got quite a bit going for it already that we're not actually seeing here. So in general, this game seems to always be improving all the time, and in general, the formula can work. My only real concern is the level of difficulty. Specifically, the level of sadism, and not wanting me to ever win, because no extra lives unless you get 100 in one go. No, one-hit kills, no continues. Do not pass go, do not collect $200. Do not see the snails coming. It's not a huge concern, but it's definitely one to keep in mind. a lot of people are going to be turned away very quickly from a game where they just keep dying over and over and over again. The reason it works for games like Dark Souls is because, for one thing, you have a means to recover yourself from what you've lost. That's a big aspect of Dark Souls. You die all the time. Hell, the whole game is centered around the concept you will die. But you can recover from your death, and that's really important. In this game, if you die, then you're literally losing all of your means of recovery. You're losing your coins, you're losing your score, you're losing your sanity. I mean, eventually you just can't recover. There's just no coming back. So I would definitely recommend another pass at the difficulty of this. But overall, I'd say it's got a very good platforming feel to it. Could it use more? I would definitely say so. So currently, there's nothing. It's not doing anything that a lot of other games haven't done. The level design's pretty good. I would say there's still some points, like right here with these hidden spikes that I didn't see before, that would kind of piss off pretty much anybody out there. But it's not a deal breaker. I mean, you know, you got that spring right there trying to hit me back into the spikes from not paying attention. You got some concept of NES hard, if you will, even if it's SMS hard, however the hell you say that. But yeah, it's an enjoyable little platformer. I would love to see more elements to it. I would love to see more things for Axel to interact with. So far, basically, we got moving platforms, we got boxes, we got some teleporters, spikes, a few enemies. But nothing that I haven't really seen before. Oh, and springs. We got springs. Hooray for springs. But we have seen a lot of these things before. It's nothing too new. It's nothing that, like, is breaking any mold or anything. We got a penguin here. How about some penguin themes, right? Alright, let's... Okay. As long as I'm not dying. Okay. Guide coins, you gotta love them. Nintendo, thank you for introducing us to that concept. I mean, these enemies, like these snails, why don't these snails go all the way around the platforms, not just stay on the bottom, you know? They could totally be slurping their way up to the top, moving down to the bottom. Now, but you see, we're also repeating a lot of level elements right here, like we're back to the little squids and bridges. Is there a secret over there? I don't want to risk it. Alright, level 3, do we got a boss? You got me a big old boss to fight? I feel like Act 3, it's kind of a thing. Yeah, this feels like a boss zone. Oh, all Mac is pissed. Legend of his secret temple. But look at this build-up. This build-up's a little over the top, because every time I die, I'm going to have to see this, aren't I? That's a lot of wait time. Okay. I feel like I'm going to die very quick, at least the first time. What am I hitting here? Oh, the gem. Ah, it's the gem. So what happens if I run out of juice? Alright, gotta get the gem. Ah! Oh! Dang, that was actually really tough to line up with. So for that, the fire came out of nowhere. How about having him spit up a fireball or something, you know? But at least that would give you an indicator the fireballs are coming. Definitely try to get something in there to help telegraph the fact that fire is about to fall down from the sky! Because believe it or not, fire falling down from the sky is not a semi-regular occurrence that I tend to deal with in life, so I don't really see it coming. Can I just hit him now? Yeah, you can definitely... You know, I'd almost feel like it'd be more jarring if he just popped right out of the ground really quickly. Alright. I want a cookie! Alright, we gotta try and dodge the fire this time. I thought I was lined up. I guess I wasn't. That's a really small radius to work with. So unfortunately, I did not beat Olmec, but I will say, for what we got so far, it's definitely on the right path. It's got the right framework. I think the level design needs another pass. I think some elements are dragging down the speed of it all. But overall, it's a solid-looking platformer, and I think it's really going to get somewhere with more time. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Axel the Penguin by Cerasoft. Go check it out. Oh, and he's telling me now to run to the far end when you hit the gem. Well, that's the thing, you gotta lead the player to the far end. Now, maybe you could do that by having the fire drop down from the center in a V shape, you know? I see it like that. I figure it's like every other tile is safe, but maybe I was wrong on that. If you have the fire falling down from the center in a V shape, like first down, next down, next down, next down, that will intuitively make the player move to the left or to the right, depending on where they are. That'd be a good way, I think, to get them where they need to go. But we're going to go ahead and get out of that. Thank you very much, Cerasoft, for submitting this. Definitely love it. If I can maybe exit out of it somehow. Wait, hang on. Shift button finally comes in handy so I can hit the X. All right, there we go. Yeah, no, I definitely like it a lot, dude. It's very nice. I would love to see the newest version. Now let's go ahead and do a little giveaway of none other than Skyhook, submitted to us by Quasi TV. Thank you so much, Quasi. Quasi has given me a few codes that I can give away to you guys. So we're going to do a giveaway right now. If you want a chance to win Skyhook, simply type giveaway in chat. And while we do this giveaway, I'm going to go ahead and look over the feedback that's been submitted by you guys. Let's go ahead and load that up. First up, Newbrew says, love the look and sound. Nailed the aesthetic. You would like to see at least one more layer in scrolling background and more juice when hitting enemies. Yeah, that's the enemy hitting is very devoid of juiciness right now. It is just so empty. Quasi, there's the guy. Thanks for the raid, buddy. Greatly appreciated. Next up, we have BP Outlaws Jeff that says, agree on the on a fast continue screen needed. Makes it too scary to experiment with a severe death punishment. Definitely agree. There's way too much, if you mess up, you will die feeling to this. And because of that, I'm really scared to try anything and get it wrong. If I get it wrong, I've lost 1/5 of my ability to survive this game. And that's a frightening prospect, to say the least. That's not a great one. Hi, your old mic sounded way better, by the way. Ooh, is that really true? I'm sad to hear that, unfortunately. I thought this one sounded pretty good. It might be because I'm not directly in front of it all the time. I'll have to look at the recording and find out about that, but thanks for the heads up, New Bruce. Monty Blanks, what's up, man? How you doing? Poto Sniper, Zelox, I saw you come in, man. How you doing? Next up, we have Poto Sniper with feedback saying, a couple of good examples of punishing gameplay without annoying restarts are Super Meat Boy and Hotline Miami. Take a look at their death designs and find a way to implement something similar that fits your game. There is no downtime in either of those games, or the downtime that is there is so minimal and controlled by the player. The biggest thing, and I've said this many times before, but I'm going to keep saying it, Hotline Miami nailed it because what they did was it was player designed. The very second the player died, at any time, they press R, they're back in the action. That's it. Press R, back in the action. No wait. Back in the action. That is so crucial. So incredibly crucial. But yeah, I definitely recommend it. Maybe I changed my sample rate. I hope I didn't change my sample rate. Oh boy. Well, I don't know. What do you guys think? How's this mic sound? How's this little baby sound? I can't switch it for this stream, unfortunately, but I can definitely find out for later. We had tested this out during one of my programming streams, and we thought it all sounded pretty good, and I thought it sounded pretty good, but I guess we'll see. I'm doing quite well, checking out some great games tonight. Serisoft, the creator of the game, says, little notes, no one ever knows the butterfly follows you, so he purposely put it there at the start of level 2 to make it more obvious. I see, because then it's a little juxtaposition from the first level where you don't have a butterfly following you. I see. Gamian says, when the game shows you that the door opens with a key, oh, we talked about this, do the camera transition. Definitely agree. It's a nice little thing to do. The Outlaws Jeff says, a lot of blind jumps / drops combined with one-hit deaths combined with long restart time equals a super rough combo. Couldn't have said it better myself. That's pretty spot on. The mic sounds fuzzy today. Fuzzy. Why fuzzy? Hang on, let me check something really quick. There's no way it should, but let me just make sure it's not on the wrong mic. No, this is the right mic. It sounds fuzzy. I'm not sure what the definition of fuzzy is. I guess we'll find out when I hear the recording. I'm playing a Skyhook on stream, that is correct. The video overlay looks like an older build. Yes, that is actually an old video because I couldn't find a new one from you in the press kit. Maybe I missed it. Hope you don't mind, but yes, that is an old video of Skyhook. It is much cooler now. Much, much cooler. Next up we have... What do we have? Who? New Bruce and... Newbruce saying, as unique as playing a penguin might be, the gameplay and level design feel very generic. It does seem very well polished, controls appear to be tight, and there isn't that big thing that sets it apart from other Q platformers. Or maybe there is, and it's not obvious. If that's true, make it front and center. Couldn't agree more. Like I was saying before, there's just not much that sets it apart. Is it solid? Sure, it's a solid platformer, but what is it that's going to get the players to notice that? What's going to get them to play your game? You always need to get that hook out early and make it obvious and make it throughout. Hooks are what get people into games, folks. It's like hissing or something. Hissing. Jeez, now, why would it be hissing? Hang on. You guys are probably going to hear my voice in a second, but I need to know now. I need to know how this sounds. I'm going to pause this lovely music, and you guys are going to hear me repeat myself. Let's see. Hello, world. How's this sound? Well, it is actually pretty loud. All right, let's murder everybody's ear holes now. Hello, world. How's
Oh,
this sound?
holy crap. You guys weren't kidding. Maybe if I turn it down. Sorry about that, guys. I had no idea that's what you guys were hearing. I don't know why you are hearing that, but I'm going to turn down my mic, and hopefully that'll help.
Let's try this. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Hello! That last part was probably really loud. Testing. 1, 2, 3. Testing.
Yeah.
1, 2... It is super staticky. When did that start? This thing was amazing not too long ago, and now it's all staticky. Oh my goodness, that's horrible. I am very sad, actually. I loved this thing when it was working. And of course, the first night I use it for any insights, everything goes to hell. Why? Why, AT2020? You were the best. I loved you. Now I have no love for you. And I'm going to have it repeat
everything
that.
Goes to hell.
Why? Why AT2020?
All right, I'm going to try unplugging it. Hang on. Come on.
Better or a million times worse? Okay, now you guys can hear me again. Rotate it. Rotate it. Let's see. Maybe if it's more like that. Let's see. Let's see. Maybe it's all about the positioning. Hello. 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 What's really weird is the volume was supposed to be at zero there, but it wasn't. Okay, let's see.
Hello.
Oh, no. No. What's happening?
What's really weird?
What's happening? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Wait, it's better? Static is gone? Then what was I hearing? That was horrible. I don't know what that was, but what the hell was that? Tell me that's not happening again. Oh, please no. What I love is this is supposed to be my first live recording, too, and you guys are going to see all of this on YouTube.
What the hell was that? Tell me that's not happening again. Oh, please no.
What
I love is this is supposed to be my first live recording, too, and you guys are going to see all of this.
Okay, hey, I'll take your guys' word for it. Sounds better, whatever. I don't know why it sounds horrible on Audacity, but I'm going to take your word for it. It sounds better. Here's the music. Let's get back to the feedback. Sounds fine. All right. This is why I have you guys. This is why you guys are here. All right, BP Outlaws Jeff says, this game would benefit a lot from basic tweening thing, from a basic tweening thing where platforms slow down as they reach their endpoints. The octopus is jumping up, the snails changing directions, the camera panning, etc. That X plus equals target minus X times 0.1 formula would juice it or lose it. And yes, BP Outlaws Jeff has linked Juice It or Lose It, which you will definitely be getting a copy of if you haven't seen it before, Seriosoft. Juice It or Lose It is one of my favorite ever videos, I would say. It was the unplug and replug technique. Ah, yes, my ancient secret. What else we got here? Noobers agrees it's far too punishing at the moment. BP Outlaw Jeff says, agree on not losing coins when you die. For earning extra lives, etc., this game is super cool looking and looks and plays tight, but a handful of tiny tweaks like Hisai is pointing out would make it really solid. Yeah, the whole getting rid of your coins for dying thing, that's just so mean. What's the point? The whole point is to recover from coins. Showcase says there is no small break or animation or quick inciting sound effects for when clearing a level, such as Mario, Sonic, etc. I'm going to chalk that up to being an alpha. It being an alpha, that's my best guess. Showcase also says boss needs a clear indicator of its weak zone. This can be done with an angry while angry handman is entering the scene. Have it twinkle or something. I like that, Showcase. Have it twinkle as it's entering the scene. That's not too subtle, but it's a nice little thing. I like that. And lastly, BP Outlaws Jeff says, would be cool if the butterfly followed you at the start of each level, and if you make it through the end on your first life, you get a bonus. But if you die, the butterfly flies away. That is a really cool idea, and I'm going to give you some bits for that one. BP Outlaw, cool idea. That's 10 bits right there. I like that. I like that a lot. Uh-oh, what's happening? I'm being informed that I need to get the mic away from my face, and I really need a pop filter. Yeah, I do need to get that pop filter. Let's see, I can probably... Don't do that, don't ever do that. I can probably turn it down a smidge, that'll probably help. I don't know what's going on with my mic. Oh, God. No, you... Hang on. It's gotta go around the world. Oh, which means I got... Hang on, gotta unplug it again. Hopefully it doesn't break it.
Please tell me it still sounds good. I kind of moved it a little away from my face because I've been told I need to do that. experimenting with new technology. Way to go, Highsight. Yeah, this thing, it's kind of weird. I can only tighten this by rotating it all the way around, and if I over-tighten it and then it goes back, it won't hold itself in place anymore. How's this sound, guys? Still good? It's all good. Highsight, when is this going to show up on YouTube? A few days, or hopefully, actually, immediately after. The whole point of this is we're going to be doing a... this, what you're seeing now, is going to go on YouTube. It's not going to be split up into segments anymore. And I'm starting to regret that decision, and there might be a few edits here and there. I don't know. But anyway, all right, last call on giveaway. Sarisoft says, if you guys want, I can tell you what I've already fixed with a quick mini list. You can go ahead and tell us what you've already fixed. Type giveaway to get Skyhook. I don't even know how many people have entered. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And the winner is... MarksFX! Congratulations, sir! You have won a copy of Skyhook, which is just released, just on its way towards releasing, or released? What is it? What's the exact state right now? I need to know this for reasons and stuff. But yes, congratulations, sir. I'm going to go ahead and copy this lovely key and whisper it to you. Marks, congratulations. Enjoy, and we're about to check this game out ourselves. Now, don't let the footage fool you. This game has improved immensely since the last time. Let's go ahead and pop over there now. All right. So this is Skyhook, and it's, for those who have seen it on my previous playthrough, a really awesome game. Yes, I've checked this out once before, back when it was in its alpha stages, and my goodness, it's come a long way since then, to say the very least. Quasi, who is here with us today, actually, or Quasi TV, as he goes by around here, has actually been streaming development of this game pretty much ever since it's been in around a little while after I showed it off, actually, if I recall. I think that's when he started, right? Well, since then, he's come a really long way himself. He's actually become a Twitch partner, streaming this game 5 days a week, as the development of the game even, and even gone as far as starting to make Twitch features for it, which is really cool. The Twitch integration's all there, and it's very, very awesome. You get to basically control, not control, but you get to be one of the bots, and if the bot wins, you get coins, and then you can spend the coins in a virtual shop to customize your character the next time they go in. It's really well put together, and I'm really happy with how he's worked with the community to develop this this beautiful Twitch play-style game. So it's very impressive. Very impressive. So, yeah, basically, if you're not already watching Quasi TV, he's in chat right now. Go follow him. He is continuing to work on things even now. It's an awesome stream. He always does a great job putting it on. He does this lovely warm-up pixel phase, followed by the game development, followed by a cool-down sketch based on everybody's suggestions. He's very active. He likes to talk to his chat while he works. I don't know how he does it, because you guys have seen me talking to my chat while I work, and it doesn't tend to go nearly as well as he does it. He actually gets people's names right. I don't know how you do that. I don't know. But I digress. Let's go ahead and jump in, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see what's changed with Skyhook. Love that sound. Now, the last time we checked this out, this was pretty strictly multiplayer only. But nowadays, instead of just the versus mode, we also have this lovely quest mode right here. And this is what we're going to be spending the bulk of our playtime checking out. So let's dive right in, shall we, to this new single player mode. Because for a lot of people who don't have people nearby to play against, this is going to be the meat of the game. So I'm going to play as Jade, just because I really like Jade's slash attack, which actually reminds me, I'm going to back up just a smidge. I believe I have the ability to change my controls, and this is something I've been meaning to do for a little while with my Xbox controller. The dodge button is going to be Y. I said the dodge, there we go, and the melee button's going to be X, if it will let me. Y, wait, no, what? No. Okay, and then the jump button is A. Okay, so I'm going to point this out. There's no confirmation that I currently have something selected. In order to change a button, I don't just press the button here. I have to press A, then I press the button I want to switch. But when you press A, that's what it looks like. It's still the exact same. So there's no real indicator that it's good to go. I would honestly just switch that to pressing the button you want it to be instead of anything else. No need to overcomplicate it. Alright, so let's test this baby out. I'm playing as Jade just because I like the way Jade slashes. That claw attack is so brutal looking. But everybody since the last time we played this game has gotten their own little melee attacks. A little punchy thing right there. She's just that powerful. Finn has this lovely chomp. Delicious. And Inara has a slash. It really adds a lot to the game, and I'm going to show you how. Because I have actually played this game more since last time. So there's also a few new skins, but I don't have the really cool ones unlocked. We'll see if we check those out. Definitely not a bug. Definitely. So each arena has their own different challenge. And I'm going to start off with one that I actually helped him create, which is kind of cheating. Target practice. This was one that he actually developed on stream. And admittedly, unlike most Indie Insights games, I have a keen insight in some of the stuff, if only because I was there when he was developing it. The idea of this is a little change from most other target practice games. The targets will actually disappear when you get too close to them. So you need to remember where they are and then go for them. I'm not gonna get a good time on this. And that's really cool. Everything has its own different spin, which is really unique. It's not just a standard break the targets. It's actually, you gotta memorize where the targets are and then break them because they're gonna be gone when you get closer. I thought it was a really cool idea, and I'm glad you took that as a suggestion. And my goodness, this is gonna be like the worst time in the history of times. Now, I'm not sure what that 10 out of 15, oh, that's how many targets done. My goodness. Yeah, I totally meant to get that one. And this one? Nope. Oh, I got greedy! I thought I could get it. No! Embarrassment. You'll notice I like to melee a lot. I don't know why. It's just, it's my thing. It's what I do. Melee's fun. Yeah, gotcha. It's probably a lot quicker if I just hit the target with my hook. Oh no, I missed one over there. As well as one up here. Well, I need to know where the other ones are, so I'll just back away. There we go. Let's try not to mess up this time. There was another one. Okay. You were merciful. I should have died there. Oh, lovely. Yeah, look at that bronze. All right, I'll take bronze. I thought that was a really cool idea at the time, and it just goes to show you the kind of creativity that can come out of streaming your game when other people give you suggestions. So let's try target practice one. Level up your grappling hook skills by taking out floating targets as fast as possible. Now this is going to be more of a standardized one, I think. And that's fine, it's good to have a little standardization. What I did before was a more advanced one. It's not what most people would start off with. Oh, man. But I will say, I'm really happy with how the melee turned out for this game. I think it does add that extra little depth that the game really needed. It was kind of lacking before. So I'm really glad that he took it under advisement. Not just from me, but from other community members. It makes all the difference. Ah, another bronze? Well, that's just mean. It would be kind of nice to know what the target times are, you know? Like, I want to know what I'm shooting for so I'm not wasting my time. When I don't make it, I can just switch right back out, you know? One way you can do that pretty easily is if the score, the timer, changed colors as time went on. So, like, it starts off gold and then it switches to silver and then bronze when the time has passed too much. I'll take a silver. No, I guess I won't. Fine. I don't want to keep guessing what it is. Let's try to explore more of this. So the real question is, for somebody who wants to play this game pretty strictly for single player, does it have enough meat on it? Because right now there is no online, and that's pretty important. The music is too loud for my voice. Let me turn that down ever so slightly. But this is a pretty vital thing. Is there enough meat in this game for just a single player experience? Now, obviously when you have friends over, that's going to change. Oh, hey, enemies. Yeah, kill them all. What's the object here? I probably should have read that. But if there's not enough for the single player experience, and there's no one around that they can play with, then a lot of people are not going to have a lot to do with this game, unfortunately. And I do mean that in the strictest sense of the term, unfortunately, because this is actually a really great experience. Now, it looks like the CPU has definitely upped its ante quite a bit. I mean, you could play against CPU all day, too. That's another way to go. But there's definitely the question of... Ah, it's Hammerhead Finn. That's like the best looking Finn. But it's definitely a concern. It's a concern for any developer who makes a pretty multiplayer-based game. And so far, I am enjoying my time with it because there is a lot of diversity in these modes. There's a lot of target practice that can be done. Yeah. Ah, no. I need to kill that one. I need the 1,000. Ah, I'm not going to make it. Dang. Oh, that's not going to count, is it? I wanted to count, though. Oh, it did count. Ha ha, gold. Sweet. Unlocked. Oh, I got the hammer fin. So this was one that he worked on specifically for people who are really good. There are bots, too. That is absolutely true. There are bots for this game. But how long do you think bots are going to sustain you? That is a real question. Wait. No, it didn't count. Oh, I found a bug. Hey, that's why we're here, right? This is just pre-release, so I just found a nice little bug for you right there. If you get a kill after the fact, it tells you it adds to the score, but the final score doesn't actually account for it. There you go. So, keep that in mind. Alright. So, this is all about scoring them goals. I don't know if there's much challenge in this one. It's really just a timing thing. Just do it as quick as you can. I keep trying to throw... What's funny is... So my first thought with this is to use the melee button to throw these. But the melee button doesn't really seem to cut it in this case. You gotta use the hookshot button. Does it matter which side I... No, it doesn't matter which side I score. So just... Oh, nope, need you. Like, I don't know, maybe I just really want to dunk these things, so it's like, dunk, nope. Ah, no. But you can't use your hook while you're carrying something. Not in Skyball. And don't miss. Don't miss. Ah, bronze score. What a shame. All right, so let's go ahead and try another one here. Is that it for King's Fall? That's it for King's Fall. Let's try Frostguard. Griffin Pat practice. That'll be good. And it sounds like I'm getting staticky on the mic. I apologize. I do not know why that is. Whoa. Ah, missed. That's why we're practicing. So I'm not quite sure what's up with the skulls giving me griffins. I know the eggs are supposed to. All right, these are directional. Kind of directional. Come on. Ah, okay, that's a big explosion. No, griffin. Griff. Griff the griffin. Come on. There we go. I do love that explosion. Ooh, that's a good effect. Not when I miss, though. Skull should be eggs. Ah, okay, fair enough. Dang it, what is with my lack of griffin skills? Look at that! So short, come on! There was an explosion nearby. That should count, kind of, maybe? I don't know. And he can't shoot straight up, can he? Oh, no, wait, this is gonna hurt! Ah! Abandoned griffin! He's about to fade into the ether. Ah, no. I think one thing that would be kind of nice for the griffin would be maybe directional, like, input somehow, so you can actually see more or less where the griffin's looking. Like, maybe if his head tilted or something, so his head, you can actually tell where it was pointing. I want to kind of try that again, because I want to focus a little more on the griffin. There's not a lot of mounts in this game. There doesn't need to be, but if you have very few, you got to make sure that they work out good. I do want to say the graphics on the griffin are exceptional. Now, what is the highest I can shoot on the griffin? It's actually... If I'm holding straight up, it is still a diagonal shot, as I kind of expect. But it's not as diagonal as I would expect it to be. I would kind of expect him to be able to tilt his head up at least a little bit more. Nope, a little more over here maybe. Nope, a little more over here maybe. There we go. Next griffin. There we go. Undead griffin, that'd be really cool. Seems like something that Finn would ride for some reason. Maybe Grimlock. Come on. There it is. Now, of course, whatever direction you're moving is the direction the griffin's going to attack. I think I'll stick with my bronze on this one. For now. So whatever direction I'm moving is the direction that it's going to attack. The exact direction. So I might be moving in an unsavory direction just to base where I want my attack to be. And it seems as though... I actually do want to run that one more time, because I want to double-check that. It seemed as though if I had the attack charging, like right here, you'll notice there's an anticipation, so I'm going to try and go diagonal, but move forward. No, okay, so if I press the shoot button and I'm holding diagonal, he's actually going to go based off of what the last area the stick is in. So that's a little odd. It's not... So if I'm holding diagonal here, or up or whatever, so diagonal, but then I go down like that, it's going to go that way. That might seem good, but if you're expecting it to go one way, and then it goes another one instead, that can be a real problem. There's also not a lot of wiggle room. Look at that. So little wiggle room. It almost seems detrimental. Seems like it'd be be easier to just get out and use your hook instead. So let's try frozen shards. Alright. Ooh, look at that. Okay. Alright. Back at what I excel at, which is the combat sometimes, especially when they kill themselves. Oh, I don't get points for them killing themselves? Wise. There we go. All double wrapped. Get over here. But they can't keep running from me. And they can't have invincibility time and shields. Come on, don't give them invincibility time. I only have so much time to get this done. If they have a shield on, I don't think they need the invincibility. I think that's kind of overkill. The invincibility just, it's restricting me more than it's really doing anything. I'm not even trying to spawn camp them. It's just, I see them and I don't really know when it's safe to attack them. Now, I hit her on the way down. I don't know if I got credit for that. So they are killing themselves, which is actually denying me the ability to kill them. I mean, look, I can't do anything about her, really. Not until she comes to face me. Look, they two of them! I needed those! If I take down the shield, can't you at least give me something? Because I at least did something. Yeah, the invincibility just kind of, it's triple wrapping him at that point. That's just a little too much. I would definitely say, take off the invincibility there. I think that'll be a big deal. Hey! Alright, the hero skin for Runa. All pink looking. Nice. Let's go back to the world map. So it seems like every level has their own person. So let's try Hidden Hood, which is going to be Inara. And let's see what kind of a skin we get for Inara. And these little unlockables are really nice. I do like them. I wonder if in the future it might be possible to do challenges for multiple players. Now, one thing if you guys didn't see right there that I like that adds a little more depth to the melee is you can actually use your melee to block a hook and vice versa. It's like a little forward-facing shield in a lot of ways. I do like that they're going a little invisible here. Oh, I didn't make it. Get back here. One. No. At least I think I'm going to get her skin for this. Let's see. Ha 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 ha! Because screw you, that's why. And that's going to be another one. And actually, you can see right there, the high score is the actual score. The 700 points is wrong because I got that after the time ran out. Though honestly, I would personally credit them for getting that at the end of the time. Just because I'm a nice guy. Pink Inara. And let's go ahead and check out the Swampland. Target practice 3. Hitting sitting ducks. Or not. Nope. Well. Yep. Just resigned to my fate at that point because yikes. What I do like is the responsiveness of the hook. I feel like it's gotten a lot more manageable since the last time I played this. Oh, well, failed on that. It seems a lot more responsive in the direction that I actually want to shoot it, and it's been a lot easier to kill enemies with it. I'm very happy with how that turned out. Ah, get back here. But you still can't shoot straight up. I guess you can. I guess my stick is just not as good as it could be. Giggity. There we go. I do like this a lot because this is like the perfect amount of minimal space to work with. I didn't actually mean to do that. Today I learned if you hook below you, you actually go down. That's interesting. That could probably come in handy for certain kill situations. Ah, no. But what I do like a lot here is that I'm getting right back in the action. In fact, you're smart. You're not even giving me the chance to say no. You're just like, okay, here you go again. I like that. What I don't like is if the music is restarting every time. Why do that? It's going to be the same song. I don't want to keep hearing the same parts. Don't restart the music. It'll be fine. It's fine. Oh, I let go. Didn't mean to do that. So, like, right here, you can just keep the music going. Or even, like, if you want to do, like, a quick slowdown on it to, like, highlight the depression of your failure right there, that'd be fine, too. Ah, nope. There we go, close enough. I'm sure some pro could really blaze through this quickly. It's set up just perfectly for that kind of movement. But I am not that pro. Music refresh is always a punishment. That's right, it's a mental punishment. It's meant to make me sad for my failure. You don't need to punish me for that. I already feel like a failure when I fail. No. No. Yeah, I love looping music because then you're not, like, hearing the same bars all the time, you know? So far I've heard probably about 10 seconds of this song, maybe a little longer, or like 20-ish. But nothing else of it. It's a beautiful song, and I'd love to hear more of it, but I never will. Come on. Last one, maybe? Nope, two more. Nope, there we go. Oh, I thought that would hit. There we go. Look at you, making that tricky little thing. No! I missed! I stopped just a little too short. Oh, this is so tricky. This is not easy. It looks easy, but it's actually really tough. And it's not because it's hard to control. It's because it really is just a tricky set of positions for these things to be in. There we go. It involves a lot of planning to fall and get back up. The way you have them under the leaves is actually really big. This is one of the few brawlers I know of that doesn't actually have double jumping. It does have wall jumping, which is great, but the lack of double jump makes it a lot easier for mistakes to be made with minimal recovery. And that's good. That's actually really good. All right, how we do? That's got to be at least a silver. You give me a silver for that. Oh, you dick. I really want to know what those par times are. Wow. I actually, see, that's what I'm loving. And that's the replayability is immediately I want to get back into it. I want to earn that silver, whatever it might be. Because I have no idea what it is. And I'm actually learning new things about how I can move. I'm like, well, hang on. Why don't I just... because I can't shoot that fast. I was like, why don't I just swing? Well, that'd be why I can't swing. All right. I'm actually genuinely curious. I wonder if... Are there any plans for leaderboards for this? Ah, dang. Missed it. Because leaderboards, I think, would fit right in with all this. And one thing I'm neglecting is I do have a dodge button, which would give me kind of an extra double jump. That is kind of the closest thing you get to a double jump in this game, is you do get a dodge that you can use to dodge upwards, but I haven't been really utilizing it. I never really do. I feel like it's like the little rascal that everyone forgets about. It's like, he's there, but there's Ralphie. Everybody likes Ralphie. And then there's the dog. Everybody likes the dog. Who cares about the other one? I don't even know if there's a Ralphie in the Little Rascals. If there is, I totally meant that analogy exactly as I said it. Yeah, I was trying to see if the melee would work. Ah, beautiful. You'll be adjusting the trophy limits. That's good. That's good to hear. Makes me feel a little less like a failure. I like swinging from these leaves, though. I think this is actually my favorite one so far, because it's just that right amount of difficult. It's not tricky. It's not like it's trying to trick you. It's really just, it's difficult, but not impossible. You could do it really easily if you take your time, but that's not the point. The point is that you want to get it right the first time as quickly as you can. Look, one thing I am noticing, though, is I'm thinking I can aim down on these leaves, but then I end up ducking, and then it doesn't actually work as I planned it to. I think that's how you actually go under trees and such. I want that one perfect run, and that's the best feeling any game can accomplish. It really is, because that is what Super Meat Boy does. It gets people invested in that one perfect run. They want it. They need it. It sustains them. And then when they don't get it, they're just going to keep trying until they do. Sometimes people will kill themselves just because they're like, well, it's not good enough, so I might as well just get to the quickest way I can. But God, the restarting is so quick. I love it. I love it. This is excellent. This is exactly the kind of thing I want to see in a single-player mode for this game. Everything about it, spot on. No critique, just love it. And I will get it later. If I weren't running a show right now where I need to check out everything, I would absolutely keep doing that. 50 Feline Frenzy. These cats are... thought you were bringing them a chest of fish. Oh no, they're going to be pretty upset when they find out it's all vegetables. 50 angry cats. Cat v. cat. Let's do it. And I only get 10 lives. I love it. Kill the kitties! Bob Barker taught me. Ah, well, okay, close enough. Melee. Now, did you down the difficulty level on these guys because of how many there are? If so, that was a wise decision. Come on. But then invulnerability. I think this is another case where the invulnerability is kind of overkill just because of how many there are. I'm gonna have to fight them forever. Spawn camping is kind of okay. It's kind of not a big deal in this case. Just because of how many I'm gonna have to deal with. Boy, I love the juiciness of that melee. I love the feel of them getting hit. It feels right, you know? It just feels spot on, exactly how I want it to. 50 cats, jeez. Oh my goodness. Are they not counting the ones that are suiciding? Oh, don't even tell me that. Well, see right there, I got beat up by invulnerability. Yeah, it's not counting the ones that are suiciding, is it? No, it's not! Oh, come on, you gotta give me that much. It's 50 cats. and I have 10 lives here. Don't deny me my kitten kills. Oh god, I'm not doing good. Maybe they didn't adjust for difficulty. Oh, I thought I got him. Or her, whatever. However the bot wishes to self-identify. Ah, no, that was a trick shot. And I don't even get the suicide kill. Oh my god, how do you beat this? This is a challenge. This is a true challenge. I will not deny. There's just so many of them, and they're so sporadic. I love the graphics of this place, by the way. The background is outstanding. The art has always been great for this game, and it really shines. It shines in this level in particular. I don't know what it is. I think it's just the kind of the culture behind it. You know, something had to build that statue. Well, you did, but I mean somebody in the game had to build it. Can they hurt each other even? I don't even know. God, all the kills that aren't mine, and now I gotta wait for invulnerability. Ah, why? 50 cats. Alright, so this is a good idea for a game mode. I mean, in practice, it makes sense. Smash did it, but the thing is, Smash also gave them a severe handicap compared to you, where they took one hit from everything to die. But in this game, everything takes one hit to die, including you, so that doesn't really work out. So how can you balance this more, aside from, you know, not having the invulnerability on them? That'd be a big one. Having simpler bosses to fight, I think I broke the game. They're not even screaming out in death anymore. Oh god, the music's gone. Oh, what have I done? Oh god, I found a bug. Oh no. And I'm dead. And it goes right back into it. And I think the sound is gone forever. I might need to restart the game real quick. So apparently, too many player voices seems to kill off sound. Who knew? Who knew? Let's check out another one. All right. So let's try Magma Cove. Target practice. Apparently I already have a high score on it. Don't know how, but I'll take it. I like this one because the floor is made of lava. I played that in school. Ah, I probably should have been better at it. There we go. This is, ooh, I thought I actually grabbed that. A little short, I guess. Story of my life. Ah, I can't get the up shots for some reason. That's probably just my controller, though. I know that the analog stick is notoriously a little finicky for it. Up we go. There we go. That's where the dodge would come in handy if I didn't completely kitten it up right there. Nope. Okay, dead. I admit I have a little trouble meleeing in certain scenarios where I think I can get it, but then I don't, because reasons. But that's mainly just on me being a bad player. Ah, you can't dip into the lava, silly kitty. That's a hot bath you ain't coming back from. It's really got a good skill cap on it. That's the thing. And this is proof of it right here. These tests are an excellent proof of the skill cap that exists in this game. I'll bet really great players could have no problem going through these things whatsoever. But then there's the players like me who can learn from this, and it'll help me reach that skill cap for when I want to play against my buddies. That's really good. That's an excellent sign for any game, especially a multiplayer-based one. But I know exactly the run I want to make, and I'm not going to quit until I get it. That's why I think these target practices are really spot on. Because they start developing muscle memory for you for the game. It's really well done. It's impressive. And I think for a single player pack, that'll be fine. Now, one thing I am noticing is there's a little, when I press the dodge button during a melee, it doesn't break me out of the melee. So if I'm in like the very final frame of the melee, then I'm not gonna get out of it in time. And that is, I was hoping that was the last one. That is dangerous. So it looks like this one is teaching me all about the dodging, because I need to use it in order to stay in safe places here. I need to use it to get up there high enough. I also can't, during a dodge, hit the hook. Ah, almost made it even. And I'm digging that. Finally, something that's kind of forcing me to use the dodge to learn about it. It works very nicely. Except for when I, you know, don't actually hit the target. This one's a little unforgiving, but it's okay that it's unforgiving because I get back in the action so quickly, it's practically unnoticeable. Plus, I guess I can also be using my melee to get a little more lateral movement, except for when I do it there, because I don't... Or a little horizontal movement. No lateral. Literally. It is sans lateral. It is all horizontal. Words, I know them. There we go. Ah, but now what I'm doing, now that I got another button in the mix, my fingers are all being like, I want to do this right now. No, no, okay, whoops. Pressing the wrong buttons everywhere. It's tough to get that shot, if only because... There it is. I don't know if I'm going to get this one before... Okay, should have clawed. Kitty likes to scratch. But I'd say the biggest thing that's killing me here, I would say, is just the fact that I'm pressing buttons and there's no response because there's no canceling. Like right there, I can't... I would think at the very least dodging should be able to cancel anything. Anytime you press dodge, the dodge is super important. It's got to be at the ready at every time. There. Oh, he didn't jump. Why didn't he jump? She. It. The. Jump. Kitty. Lava bad. Did anyone teach you that? And... Nah, that was just me forgetting buttons. Muscle memory. It's a feature. There we go. I wasn't going to be able to get that guy anyway. Once you miss it, you pretty much missed it. No, stop sliding. Go up! Go up! Oh my god, I'm failing miserably at this. There is a double jumping. Oh yeah, yeah, the dodge is kind of a double jump thing. Ah, no! If I could just... One thing that I do notice is, like, I want to go up, but then I get used to the idea of being clung to the bottom and going straight up. But then if I'm just slightly on the side, just a little bit, I'm actually going to be stuck to the side instead. And then I end up kind of dying because I'm like, why aren't I going up? There it is. Oh, but I need a dodge. Right. Boy, this is a really tricky one, and I love the difficulty ramp up. This is, like, the perfect challenge for expert players. Just need to remember buttons. No! Alright, hook. Right. That little thing that actually helps me get around. I should probably use that more often. It's really addictive. And that is really the best thing that you could ask for in a game like this, is addiction. Get the player hooked from your mechanics from the get-go. And they'll be in for life. See, right there, I'm stuck on the side. That's not what I wanted to be. I just wanted to go upwards. And I understand the trick for kind of determining that, because... I mean, it is a trick to determine that. It could be a solid platform, and there should be no way you should be able to get up that way, but... Ah, there should be some kind of a way to determine it. There's not a really good way to... When you slash and you're standing still, you will move forward. I need to point that out for anyone who didn't notice. So if you have a target directly on top of you, you're going to be slashing forward when you might want to be just attacking them, you know, directly and not moving. It would be kind of nice if there was a melee you could do while freestanding instead of having to resort to always moving forward with your attack. Because there are definitely going to be scenarios that call for just standard movement. Yeah, got it. Oh, really? Wasn't there a way I could... Okay, maybe. Ho-ho, that was close. Bonk! See? And now I'm proud of myself. It's that kind of addiction where you're just proud of yourself for accomplishing it after so many tries. It's grand. It's really grand. I love it. And last one, the floor is lava. Of course it is. Let's check it out. Ah, coins and gems. Lovely. Oh, God. Oh, God. Well, I ain't getting those gems. It's gonna be a piss-poor collection. So this one's all about score, it seems. And, you know, living. Ah, no. That ain't... Oh, right. Dodging. Remember, you must dodge. How can I get down there? It seems the floor actually moved up a lot quicker the first time. That might be a bug. I don't know if anyone saw that. Oh, just crazy old hindsight making up his stories. Ah! Back in the action. Yeah, it seems like I have a lot more lead time this time around than I did the first time. Might be a little bug. Jump up. Go, 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 kitty. Go, kitty. Nope. Bad kitty. You died. You're not supposed to do that. It's bad for you. Maybe it's because the lava is starting before it actually says go. Something to keep an eye out for. Up. 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 Okay, go. Just keep going. No, go up! Ah! I want to live! Why won't you let me live? Ah, no. Ah, almost. Almost. Kitty, no! Stop dying. I'm not even going for the coins anymore. I just want to live! Ah! My greed. My greed will get me killed so much. Over and over, time and time again. Ah, I actually saw it like poof off of it for some reason. I saw a little kick of dust when it attaches. Why didn't you let me live? What have I done to offend thee? What god have I angered? The magma god, clearly, but that's beside the point. God just really wants this cat dead. Ah! This is really intense. It's got that really quick movement to it. It's not a slow, gradual movement. It's just, you gotta go. You got no time. Go with it. Flow with the mess-ups as best you can. Oh, this ain't gonna happen. Oh, go, kitty. Oh, wow, okay. Well, I tried. Alright, let's try another path. Because this one ain't really driving. I love that flip-up move. Feels smooth. I can't keep getting caught on sides. That's gonna be a huge killer in a lot of scenarios. And I like how the coins do lead the way sometimes. Ah, but you saw it, right? You guys saw the dust-off kick right there? It's like it attached, but it was just a little too far out, so it didn't count. That's gonna be the thing that makes a player go, ah, really? Kind of like when I go, ah, really? Right there. There's definitely that trickiness to it. You gotta make sure you have just the right length. I'm not sure if that's intentional or if it's a bug. Keep going. I just want to live. Yeah, there we go. A little more height. A little more height. Ooh. Oh. Oh my god. How high is this? Oh. Oh. I see the lights. Oh. Oh, that is so crazy intense. And I got the platinum for it. Oh, wow. I'll take it. I'll take it. No complaints whatsoever. Outstanding. I would like an unlock for that, but whatever. I won't be picky. So I think aside from Skyball Challenge 2, which we're going to look at right now, I think this has quite a bit of value to it. And there's a good amount of replayability, too. That's the thing. These challenges are very challenging to get perfectly right. And I'm just gonna go. I'm just gonna. Oh, you're not even gonna give me the chance to do the honorable thing and die, are you? Well, that just proves that you can score and die, and it won't matter. Scoring is more important than dying. So wait, what happens if I? Because it looks like my score goes up either way. I want to see exactly what the lose con is in this. What happens if I just kind of throw all these off? And I'll go with this one. Whee! What's the lose condition exactly? Oh, it increases my time. Oh, that's actually really smart. I like that a lot. So you can score as many as you wish, but for each one you miss, it tacks on time. Oh, crap. Well, oh, because I got to shoot from that angle. Makes sense. Go a little higher. And my time determines my score. That was actually a pretty good run. But I missed one, so... Oh, well, okay, gold. I'll take it. And that is the single player that was recently added to Skyhook. And I think it is actually full of replayability, plus you get little unlockables when you do well. But let's see the meat of this game. This is the true multiplayer mode. And hang on. No, I have to. I have to play as Hammerhead Finn. It is not an option. But that's the real meat of this game, and I'm curious to see, or rather, this is the real meat of the game. I'm curious to see how well the new system holds up in terms of good old Deathmatch or Steam Tank. That's a new one. Oh, no, it's not. That's the limited ammo. Sky Slayers earn points by killing enemies, will lose points by killing yourself. Skyball. Let's do a good old-fashioned Deathmatch with 3 lives. And there are special mutators, but we're going to skip those for right now. Let's just jump in. Let's see what the real meat of this game is, and if it still holds up. Love that concept art, by the way. Whew. Outstanding. Oh, there's two hammerhead. Oh, no, it's just me. He's just red. I like that his hammerhead animation is actually him headbutting. Outstanding. So, yeah, it still really holds up well. Look, everybody died. Yay. And now I'm invisible, but nobody else is. Yay. But admittedly, the bots are still pretty derpy. They do tend to kill themselves a lot. Oh, one of them got me. I like the hammerhead fin's soul. It looks just like him. Ah, I got nommed on. But it's okay, I got one more life. Now, the real meat of this would be happening if I was playing against other humans. Uh-oh. Oh, I deserve that death. The real meat of this game would be if I were playing against other humans. But even just playing normal is still pretty damn fun. It's still got a really good feel to it. Let's actually rematch. Oh. I was hoping the rematch doing on random would actually change the map because it would be random map, you know? So, something you might want to look into. If you choose random and you do rematch, a new map would be great. Though I'm sure that does take time to load, doesn't it? Oh, he actually almost dragged me down with his corpse because I was hooked on it and he was falling. Ah, no. But the bots do range anywhere from, like, killing themselves constantly to killing you constantly, so you're not quite sure what to expect when you fight them. And that's part of the fun, I guess, but really, playing against other people, that's where the real fun is going to be, I find. God, I love this. It's his eyes. That's what it is. It's his eye placement that really gets me about Hammerhead Finn. Hilarious. He just looks like he shouldn't be, but he is. Oh, look at him. Look at him dodging. There it is. Oh, I love it. I love everything about it. That clutch victory and the words that come with it and everything. It's nice little things like that that really make this all really worthwhile. Let's go ahead and do... Let's try another level there. Absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And I want to hit you with the thing. See, this is the other mount in the game, which is the cannon ship thing, which actually leaves you kind of a sitting duck in a lot of scenarios. Because while you're in it, you move very slowly. If you don't have the distance, you don't have the power. Oh, wow, did I just get a 2-for-1? I think I did. That explosion was awesome. I loved how that impact looked. Oh, okay. Is that what we're doing, huh? Is that how we're playing? Really fun gameplay. And what more could you possibly ask for out of a multiplayer experience? I love the physics of the hooks. If I haven't said that already, I love the ability to just kind of swing around. Come on. Haha, trying to go underground. I think I can do that too, can't I? Yeah, there it is. That's his dodge, actually. I really like that. But he's on the ground. Oh, crap, I was going to have a perfect game. A taunt button would be lovely. That would be like the time to taunt. That's the best taunt I got right there. So yeah, Skyhook. It recently finished its development cycle, and I believe it is a really fun time, especially if you have other people you can play against. That is where it's going to shine the brightest. You have some friends over, you have a little controller couch co-op party, you're going to have a wonderful time. Keeps track of logs and everything, though I would like it if you could keep track of people individually, like, you know, how Smash has different names for people, like four-letter names or something like that. That'd be pretty sweet. Then you could have little logs and compare your stats and everything. But even without that, it is just a really fun time to get down and dirty with your friends and just murder each other with grappling hooks. Ladies and gentlemen, this has been Skyhook. Go check it out. It's on Steam now. All right. So, yeah, I'm kind of hoping I hear sound from this. Am I going to hear? I have no sound anymore. I don't know what happened, but I just don't have sound. Hang on, let me... Maybe it's my mixer. Maybe my mixer screwed up, but for whatever reason, I have absolutely no sound. Yeah, my mixer froze. How did that happen? Hopefully you guys are hearing everything okay. I'm going to try to restart the mixer. Can you guys... You guys can hear me, right? You can hear everything, right? Well, while that's going... Yeah, look at that. It won't open. Oh, wow. Something really bad has happened, and now I can't hear things. But as long as you guys can hear things, that's great. Let me go ahead and do the next giveaway while I try to sort that out. Quasi, thank you so much for the submission, man, and thank you so much for the keys, because we're about to do another giveaway. Giveaway! If you want your chance to win a copy of Skyhook, type exclamation point giveaway now while I go over the feedback. I say your game is more fun with sound on. Yeah, I know. I'm going to try and sort that out. I apologize if we don't have time to get to the feedback. I don't know why this is happening. I've actually never had this happen with the voice meter. Let me try shutting it down and restarting it. That's really brand new. I've never had this happen before. Of course it would be the one night that I'm like, I'm going to do this live. No, I think we're going to have to see edits, unfortunately. I think there will be edits. Why does open that? Everything might go quiet for a second. Ah, there it is. I have sound. We're good. Okay, I have just confirmed what I've thought this whole time, and that's that my mixer is total crap, and I'm going to have to get rid of it. Because, I don't know, it's really bad, and that's not okay. How's the crackling on the mic, guys? Is the crackling still bad? I don't know what's happening with that either. The one night! It worked so fine when we tested it before, but not tonight. No, sir. Alright. Let's go ahead and check out this feedback you guys have submitted. Nubu says, hard to aim with the Griffin, possibly hard to aim in general. Maybe a crosshair or something of that sort would help. I would agree a crosshair would be nice, but I don't think it's a necessity. I think the crosshair would kind of give away too much information for everybody playing. But something subtle, like what what actually they do with the hook is, if you didn't see, the arm will actually move in the direction it's going to shoot. It gives you a general idea, but not a lot. The Griffin, on the other hand, you really don't get much of anything, so... I don't know. Fred of the sound is A-okay. That's good. That's good to hear. Mic seems good. No crackling? Okay, good. I thought somebody said that there were crackling. Yes, those are legitimate quotes. I can't deny them, unfortunately. This is why your bot is better than him, Quasi. My bot? Oh, his bots. The bots have strategy. I have none of that. Did I say that during his stream? I might have, actually. That might have happened. Anyway... BP Outlaws Jeff says, watching this leaf level, it might be interesting if there was some kind of a last-second save ability, like making the hook shot out twice as fast if you're near the bottom of the screen. Oh, so you can get that Super Smash Brothers, I'm falling and I'm about to die, no, I'm back, woo, kind of recovery feeling. No idea what that would do to the balance, though, or if that would be too confusing. Maybe a double jump or something? Yeah, it has the double jump, and you said, oh, forget about that. Yeah, there is the double jump, but... But that's more of an advanced tactic. A lot of people, I think, will go into the game not really using the dodge much at all at first, but once they understand the usefulness of it, I think it would work out nicely. BP Outlaws Jeff says, digging the screen shake when you hit stuff has a nice, solid impact feel. The other guy on Twitch says, have a faded target for the next one you're supposed to hit so you can plan ahead for movement. Is that... I don't know which one that's in reference to, because there were a few hit the target ones. Have a faded target for the next one you're supposed to hit so you can plan ahead. Oh, yeah, for the ones where they just kind of appear. That would be a good idea, like a translucent one almost, so you can kind of just plan ahead. I think it kind of works the way it is, honestly, because it kind of gets you moving towards it immediately. You see the flash and you're like, that's the one. That's what I'm going for. And then it just kind of works. Hi, Sai, you may have missed some of the sound engineer guy stuff. You may have missed it, but some sound engineer guy... said that the fuzzy stuff was from static buildup, which gets cleared up when you unplug. And don't unplug a hot mic. Well, I did it. What are you gonna do? Do you have any idea what builds up that kind of stuff? Because I don't even know what I could have done to have caused that static buildup. That's a genuine concern for me. Was that Transient? Was Transient in here? Did I miss him? Who was the audio guy? I need to hear that. I think Juju said it. Oh yeah, Juju probably would have known that, wouldn't he? Okay, that's interesting. By the way, I do need to thank all my new followers. I'm going to do that once I am able. I don't have sound alerts while I'm doing Indie Insights for reasons, but... Juju. Juju says, don't restart the music when you die. It makes each track great on the player. Absolutely. PPL Laws Jeff says, or does it already have... Yeah, it does have the double jump. Ignore you. I'm just going to delete all that part. Good job mixing up the challenges and level designs to get the most variety out of the out of stuff you do with your mechanics. Absolutely. There's a lot of variety in those single-player games, and it helps teach the player the more advanced tactics for the multiplayer side, which I love. I do love that a lot. Outlaws says, digging the environment changes... digging that the environment changes a bit as you play, with lava going up and down. A lot of potential there. Nubru says, the lava stage has great orange lighting on most of the platforms, but the platforms closest to the lava... are metallic and have no glow on them at all, and it really takes away from the atmosphere. Admittedly, I didn't notice that, but I think I would have noticed if it did have the kind of lava glowy effect on it. So I would agree with that. That'd be a good get. Good observation, New Bruce. I'm gonna give you some bits for that one. I'm gonna give you 5 for that one. I like that one. No one's won the giveaway yet. We're still doing it. I don't have the overlay up. I don't have an overlay anymore. I'm using my own bot now, so he doesn't actually have a screen to show you who's in. Next up, and lastly, BP Outlaws says, dig the art in the castle level, where the platforms are on top of the faded columns versus just floating magically. The column's darkness is just dark enough to know what's solid and what isn't. Yeah, it was super intuitive. I had no problem knowing what I could and couldn't go through. It was really well done. In general, all the levels are really well designed and really beautiful. I'm really happy with how this game has turned out, and I encourage it for anybody who is interested in any kind of couch co-op experience or just beating the crap out of some bots in a really good Towerfall Ascension-esque gameplay with grappling hooks. Couldn't recommend it more for anybody in that kind of niche. Me gusta, sir. Me very gusta. All right, and last call on the giveaway. Type giveaway to try to win Skyhook. And if you don't win this time, there will be one more afterwards, so don't worry about it. One more after our final game. Yeah, I think we're going to end up doing some edits for tonight's video, unfortunately. Between the sound screw-up and everything, probably something I got to do. But I'll figure something out. Thanks, dude. Learned a lot from this, as always. Quasi, it's why I'm here, baby. I hope you're taking notes. If not, the stream will be up with some edits later. So, unfortunately, it might not be up immediately after, guys. Sorry to say. I wonder if it has anything to do with the fact that I'm recording at the same time that I'm streaming. Not recording like I usually do, but recording through OBS itself. I guess we'll see. Last call. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and the winner is... I'm going to give Hodenk a second. Try quick. There it goes. And the winner is New Bruce. New Bruce, thank you so much for always being a strong supporter of Indie Insights, and congratulations on the win. I'm going to go ahead and give you a key now. Have fun, sir. Have a good time. And why is it that no one who's won a giveaway yet has an icon? I set this up so specifically. If you have an icon, you got to see your icon in the overlay. I worked so hard on that, too. You got to set up icons, guys. I believe in you. You can do this. All right. So let's go ahead and move on to our final game of the night, which is currently only known as Dragon Game. Dragon Game is by Jeff VP Outlaw, who is actually in stream right now, so you can always chat directly with him. This game is very much a work in progress, and one thing I really want to do with it, we need to workshop a title for this game, because currently it has none. So as we're playing, I want you guys to help me come up with a good title for this game. This was originally a Ludum Dare entry that is they're attempting to turn into a full-on product. So let's go ahead and give them a hand with this. Let's check it out, everybody. And there goes the black. There we go. Thank you for testing my game. The sound effects are all temporary / crappy right now, and don't worry about testing everything in the menus. The main thing I'm looking for is feedback on gameplay, controls, difficulty curve, if you can tell what's going on, or how exactly to play. That kind of thing. There's a green button for the main menu that will take you to the feedback form you can fill out. Well, I think the recording will suffice. All right, it's dinner time. Let's go press down or trigger R to eat. All right, so let's, I'm nom. New high score. That was easy. I just had to eat a piece of chicken. I'm going to eat things. So it looks like some of these are pre-smashed, or are they trying to build them? No. No. I do love the way the buildings hop. In fact, what I really like is the way they're at different angles every time they drop back down. That's really great. So I don't know what these guys are doing, but I'm not happy about it. No. This is my destroyed house. All right, so I'm in the danger zone right now. I don't know why I can't eat these guys, though. They're just kind of floating. Could be a bug. I'm going to eat some cows, though. Starving. Don't be starving. I need to eat. Oh, if I double tap, I dash. Yeah, there seem to be some guys who just are not okay with me eating them, so they just don't get eaten. So I'm trying to press down, but down doesn't seem to do anything. It's only the right trigger that seems to actually eat. So I think you're lying to me. I can breathe fire. That's good. So I gotta break the houses, right? And then that will release the villagers that I can eat. Yeah, there we go. That's what we're looking for. Get over here. Get over here. Get nommed. There we go. And I'm moving a bit quicker now. Okay. So the more I eat, the quicker I move. Now we're talking. See, it was a little bit of a slow beginning right there. Oh, look at that fireball. Oh, wow. That actually took everything out of me. Oh, boy. Come on. So one fireball basically took everything out of me. That's a little overkill, I think. There, I'm at hungry levels. I'm getting there. Satisfied. Satiated, right? Eat the cows, eat the chickens. What a big old... Ooh! Ho, 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 ho! That is so much more effective than a fireball. Rampage! Oh! Yes! Om nom nom nom. Om nom nom. Okay, that does not last nearly long enough. That's amazing. Knights have arrived. New egg. Protect the egg. Hey, get away. Get away from my baby. That's my baby. What's this? Unlimited dash. All the dashing. Oh, my God. This looks so juicy. I love everything about how this looks. Where's my egg? Where'd my egg go? Did I lose my egg? There should be like an off-screen indicator for it or something. Oh, my God. Little baby dragon. Oh, it's a little baby dragon. Oh, my God. I'm a mommy. Yeah. Smash, smash it! Oh! Oh! Smash, smash, smash! Oh, that's so beautiful. Archers taking aim! Get out of here, archers. So, when I'm not in rampage mode, I lose my power really, really, really quickly. But when I'm in rampage mode, it's basically a free-for-all. I just need to go crazy. Kill all the things. Madness, madness, happy, fun, smashy time! And then I'm just kind of back to normal sadness. Now, one thing I do like is I do rather like the way that the game changes its music depending on what's going on. If I'm in rampage mode, it gets all, murder everything. But when I'm not in gameplay mode, or when I'm not in rampage mode, it's just all like, yeah, you know, dragon, whatever. Yay. Where's my egg? Is it dead? Did my egg die while I was rampaging? I feel like I should be eating some of these people as I fly by them with my mouth open. I'm just, boy, this village has a lot of people. Now, I'm not quite sure what the lose situation is in this game. Unlimited dash, unlimited dash, unlimited jump. Not unlimited fire, though. The unlimited jump doesn't do too much for me, I don't think. Except for, like, the first one. The first one is the one that really matters, I think, because it gets all the villagers out in the open for me to eat. And my little babies to eat. Ah, badoosh! Nice. Nom, 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 nom. Catapults everywhere. How can I destroy the catapults? I guess I just need to fire on them or something enough. Not sure how much health I have. Get the catapults. Oh my God, there's so much dragon. The rampage is super badass. I love the way the screen changes and everything too. It's so cool. It looks really great. It plays really great. But I feel like that's where the game is at its best, is during rampage mode. This whole downtime is really just... Oh, mash buttons. It's really just kind of buying you time to get into rampage mode again. Everything between now and then is just kind of... purgatory? I think that's the best term for it. Honestly, it's purgatory. I'm just kind of blowing time until I'm back into super awesome rampage mode. So right now, it feels like rampage mode is really the best time, but it's not the most common time. Unlimited fire. Try to find a way to make non-rampage mode just as engaging and enjoyable. Right now you move really a little almost too slow in my opinion while you're not in rampage mode. Ah, now I'm getting frozen all the time. That's not fun. I can't really do much to fight it because I need to eat these guys, but if I set them all on fire, then I don't get to eat them and then I don't get in rampage mode. It's kind of a vicious cycle. And every time I get hit, I lose my hunger, or I gain hunger, and I'm getting chained into... all that freaking... but I just want to go into rampage mode again. Why can't I just be in rampage mode? I'm just in sad times now. This is... I'd say the wizards are definitely the low point of the game. That's when you're just not doing anything. You're just waiting to get into rampage mode again. But you can't because you're constantly getting hit. And you're moving too slow to get away from a lot of this stuff. Like, how can you dodge that? Is there a way to dodge that? Like, jumping maybe? There we go, rampage mode. Kill all the things. Yeah. Rampage mode's fun. I like Rampage mode. So I guess the core meat of this is going to be to get as big of a score as you can, right? But how big of a score can you get? And how can you keep the player entertained enough? I was actually frozen in Rampage mode. That was different. There we go. Gotta dash first and then go in the air with fireballs. That's where the money is. Now, there's a lot of flashy things going on here about 100 times score or something like that, and, you know, bonus combo and unlimited fire. But I think a lot of it gets lost in translation after a while, because it's just, all I'm really focusing on is the concept of building my, or lowering my hunger. That's about it. Now, the Rampage meter, once you're in Rampage mode, it's a constant descent down. I don't see any way to get it back up while in Rampage mode. You gotta basically lose Rampage mode to get back into Rampage mode, and that feels like you're slowing down the fun aspect. If I'm in Rampage mode, I want the ability to stay in Rampage mode. I don't want it to be like a short little fun time thing and then back to normal. Back to normal, boring old non-Rampage mode. Try to find a way to chain Rampage into Rampage. That's where the real fun's gonna be. I don't think I even collect score while I'm in non-Rampage mode. No, I do. It's just very minimal by comparison. Oh, crap, what's this? What's the purple thing? I don't know, but I'm getting way too comboed now. At this point, the game is playing itself. I'm really just not... I can't do anything. I just am dead. So at a certain point, it's just basically you lose. And that's how a lot of arcade games are, but it feels less subtle here. It feels more like I just lost because it was my time to go, finally. It didn't feel like as much I screwed up. It feels just like the time has passed, you have done your deed, and how do I... There we go. Nope, backspace. It feels like the time has passed, and now you just, you're done. And then you just go right back to what you're doing. Now let's talk about controls. R2 to eat or down. Down doesn't work, so it's just R2 for me to eat right now. I think square is the better eat button, honestly, because it's going to be the button you're going to press more often, and it's where my thumb is, right? It's where my thumb is. That's what I'm going to want to press, is the square button. Jumpy. Come on. Get out of your house. I need to eat you. There's only like one of you? What, you just a single guy living on your own? This is medieval times. Supposed to have a wife by now or die from syphilis. It's one of the two. You don't get both. I can't run faster than them. I'm so hungry. And I just see them floating around. It's like they're taunting. That ain't cool. Stop floating around. Let me eat you. I guess I just eat the farm animals, which is a really slow part of the game. I keep getting inside of half-eaten buildings, and I can't eat them then. Can y'all just leave the buildings so I can eat you and get into Rampage mode and have fun with this game again? Please? Oh, boy. You need to stop fortifying walls. I just need to spam my fire, I think, until I break everything. Oh, hello. I don't know where you came from, but thank you. Thank you, gift from the gods. Yes! Leave your houses more often. Boosh! Yeah! Oh, wrong button! I did it again. There we go. Yes! There it is. See, it's a big snowball effect. You have a lot of fun with this game when you're in Rampage mode, but it's the getting to Rampage mode. That's the tricky part. That's the part that really needs to be looked at very carefully. New egg! Defend the egg! And the more you eat, the faster you can get into Rampage mode, which is another kind of strange thing. But if you try to use any of your powers that help you get into Rampage mode, you end up losing them. Rampage mode is great. That's the biggest takeaway. Rampage mode is excellent. More like that. Find a way to make that happen. Be more of the gameplay like that. Hell, if you could even self-trigger Rampage mode, that'd be cool. Yeah, if I eat during Rampage mode, nothing. There's no point in eating during Rampage mode. Don't do it. Tis a waste. Tis a waste of perfectly good Rampage. No, fireballs. It's time for fireballs when in Rampage mode. I honestly wish the Rampage mode wasn't even based on eating. I wish it, like, fireballing people would do it too, you know? Yes! Kill them all. Oh my goodness, yes. I got a new little baby. Mama. Nom nom. Combo reward. Ooh, give me that. Yes, free rampage. Free rampage is the best rampage. While in rampage mode, I should really be dashing all the time. There's no need for me to walk in rampage mode. That is such a non-necessity. Such an unwant. I should always be running. Don't make me double tap. Nom 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 nom. Turrets are built. Yes. And I don't think the villagers should ever be able to run faster than me. That seems like a big waste of dragon feet. I like how nomming the catapult users doesn't actually do anything. But I am glad to hear that some people have also feedbacked on the fact that it just feels like you lost because it was your time instead of you lost because you messed something up. It's actually extra stressful because you're putting all that text in place like saying, eat something quicker, you'll die. It's like, I can't, I'm frozen. I would say the biggest cock blocker in this game is definitely the wizards, just because what do you do? There's no real defense against that. There's no counterplay. You just take it. Take it like a dragon. No, I need to kill the wizards over there. There they are. But the rampage mode is super sweet and super cool and really great. More rampage. Ah, mash the buttons. Mashing buttons. That's something a lot of games do. Mashing buttons. It's an odd concept, really, because when you're mashing all the buttons and you finally break out, you end up triggering something you might not want to. What do I mean? Well, let's say I was mashing the buttons there while I was unfrozen, and then I ended up using a fireball, and then I lost all my rampage juice because I used the fireball. How's that a good thing for the player? It's not. Now, I could just mash the directional buttons, but then I'm not mashing all the buttons, and then I'm losing potential to get out, and that's kind of an issue. Now, I'm not saying this game is the only game guilty of doing that. A lot of games do that, and it's something that I think a lot of games don't consider. Mashing buttons is actually very counterintuitive to the player. Now, if you want them to do a certain sequence, which you can actually specify on screen to get out quicker, that's a bit more skillful, and that feels better overall. That would be a good way to go, I think, is do this sequence to break out. Or at least break out quicker. You can still have time be a factor. Now, there's a lot of knockback on these things, too, which has stopped me from getting the good stuff. Killing all the people. Oh, I'm dashing. There we go. Yes. Eat them all. Visual style, though, top-notch. Can't say a dang thing about that. It's pretty damn spot-on. I love it. I love the visual style. I want to eat y'all. But I'm frozen. It makes it extra tricky. If nothing else, this is a village of architects and sons and daughters of architects because, goddamn, they build things quick. And now it's murder time. It's okay, I'll have it all back up in like a second. I'm kind of confused about the time scale of this game, I must admit. They build these things so quickly, and yet I can't imagine it takes me that long to like move from point A to point B, so why do they build so quickly? How does this happen? The time scale is so strange. Now, you could say I could jump to try to dodge some of these things, but the problem is that jumping uses a lot of my power. And that is going to lead to a longer wait time on the rampage, which is the exact opposite of what we ever want. Like, every time I do something to dodge, I just end up, there we go, losing rampage out of it. Not a fun feel. Is bad for me. But I do love the juiciness of these numbers. There's a lot of juice here. Priestess is arriving. Oh boy, I'm gonna be hindered and slowed and all that fun stuff. Kill the priestess? Nope, can't because fireballs don't work in here. I see. So that's and rampage mode, haha, yes! Ah, but you can break down the barriers! Because priestesses are weak sometimes! Ah, no, no, there's a perfectly good buffet over there! New high score! Ah, no! I'm stuck and I'm getting knocked over and I can't eat nothing! I'm just mashing the eat button and hoping it works! Nom nom nom! Please, please nom noms! So close! No! It's almost enough! Yeah! Yeah! Come from behind victory. Until I die in a second. Kill the priestess. No priestesses allowed. Dang, that guy just charged at me with a horse. That's an innovative way to try to kill me. So at this point, it's just things everywhere. It's just there's nothing to do. What can we do to stop the things everywhere thing? Have you considered wave-based combat? Or like, you know, even scenarios. Have you considered, instead of making it arcade style, make it like scenario-based? Facing different things at different times, in different orders, causing different things to kill you. Must murder, eat, survive, make babies. Why can't I eat in here? Yeah, the big jump saved me. I'm not. Is it addictive? It's actually really addictive, but it's only going to be addictive for so long. At a certain point, you can tell the game is just saying, okay, he needs to die now before he realizes just how little else there is to do. Which is unfortunate, but it is how it goes. Kill the priestess is small and big. Like, I mean, hey, princess, what? Hang on. I want the princess, but she's over there. And I'm, like, surrounded in two bubbles. Ah, no, but there's a princess, and I want to eat it. Ah, come on, eat. Just manja. The random jump seems to help a little. I like the way you zoom in on the camera as I'm dying. That's pretty cool. It really drives the point home that you are going to die unless you move. Ah, come on. No. I've come so far. Princess must eat. Ah! No. Dang. If only I wasn't on the other side of the screen. Oh, well. So there does seem to be a maybe final objective. I don't know. But either way, it is a nice, neat little game, and it is very enjoyable and very juicy, but it clearly needs more, and I think you know that. I mean, it's still in its alpha, and it's still called Dragon Game, but we need to come up with a better name than Dragon Game. So what we're going to do is, during this last giveaway, we're going to come up with... No. The game is going to go to whoever gives me the best name for this game. That's how it's going to work. If you want your chance to win, you need to give me the best name you can for Dragon Game. And while I do that, I'm going to be looking through feedback. Submit the name that you came up with through exclamation point feedback. Nubru says, the dragon is very endearing with its stubby tail and dog-like barking sounds. Nubru says, love the rampage effects in metal. Oh, it's so good. He also says, seems like a great metal game. Soulfoam says, rampage mode is super badass. It really is. Also welcome, Soulfoam. Nubru says, Dragon Feast. Sharkbait says, might be a good idea when you see people building that you stomp. When you stomp, they fall down and then you can eat them. That would be good, Sharkbait. I'm going to give you bits for that. I like that idea. Give Sharkbait, let's say, I'll give you 10 bits for that. I like that idea. There we go. And what else we got here? Sharkbait says, BP Outlaw Jeff says, honestly, the biggest issue is he's not sure how to get the player to die without making it feel unfair. The rampage is so powerful that you end up being unstoppable, but getting bored because it's so hard to die. But stuff like freezing and protective bubbles around villagers is really frustrating. Totally open to ideas. Well, BP Outlaw, I agree. That is definitely a big issue with the game, no doubt. And it's going to be a tough one for you to overcome because it is the core gameplay of the game. That is the core gameplay. So how do you overcome your own core gameplay mechanics? You have to redesign them. It's really the only way. So let's think on that. Rampage mode is amazing, but you feel far too overpowered. And normal mode is boring, and you feel super underpowered. But where's that middle ground? Why is it that there isn't much of a middle ground there? You only really die when the rampage gets really intense because you're so defenseless. So why is that? Why not make you less defensive, but, you know, like, let me do my full jump, but maybe not give me infinite speed. Let me do half a jump, I don't know, without it affecting my rampage bar. Let me do my fire breathing, but don't make it as weak as it is right now, or affect my rampage for doing it. Don't let me dash, only let dash happen during rampages, because that feels like a core staple of it all. Only let me jump and fire breathe outside of a page, but make it weak, but not as weak as it currently is, and don't let it affect the rampage meter. Can't stress that enough, because you need ways to fight back. That's what it is. Right now, you just don't have any way to fight back, so gotta give them away. All right, so let's see what kind of names we have right here. First off, we have Nubru saying Dragaside. I think Dragaside would be better. I'm gonna paraphrase that to Dragaside. Next up, we have Frederer saying Dragon Dining. I kind of like that one. Next up, PP Outlaw, who is the creator of the game, says, also not sure anyone will play more than a couple of times. Yeah, that is always the dilemma when it comes to arcade-style games, isn't it? You're going to have to give them progression somehow. And you can do that through levels and such. Sharkbait says Dragon Page. I see what you're getting at. Dragon Age, I don't know. Nubru says, reminds you of Swords and Soldiers. Visually and even a bit gameplay wise, check it out. There you go, you might be able to get some gameplay there. The other guy on Twitch says Village Destroyer, Wrath of the Dragon. I think it's a little long. Water Balloon says Burrito. I could go for a burrito right now. Ace Jester, welcome, says Dragon Jaunt. I like the word jaunt, that's a fun word. The Dragon Jaunt. And the other guy on Twitch says, or Rage of the Dragon. And was there any more? Ace Jester says, outside of the Rampage, you want to use a combo system for all of your attacks. You have the basic button mashing controls, but more complex ones could perhaps mitigate more damage towards yourself and deal damage to the villagers. What about like a guard button? What about a button that's really based around holding it down and then taking blows, and then after you take enough blows, or depending on how much damage you take, when you release, maybe the dragon just like goes full Hulk roar mode, and then everything gets knocked back, or like the damage is dealt to them, depending on how much damage was dealt to you during that. Something like that would be kind of good. Or if you could even time the hits that are coming toward you, that might be a little trickier, considering how many things are coming at you. I like the idea of like being in a shell, you know, just like wrapping yourself around your wings or something, and then roar when he's all pissed off after something like that. Sergeant Wireless, how not to drain the dragon. That's pretty good. Hometown Dragon Buffet. Ah, good times. I actually really like the name Dragon Dining. That one really resonates with me right there, by Freddier. What do you guys think of that? Dragon Dining. I do also like Dragon Jaunt, if only because I don't see the word jaunt often enough in the world. Someone mentioned a sort of Colossus from X-Men Spaz move, where he pushes everything away for a second and give you breathing room. Yeah, I think it would go really, like, I mean, you have a Dragon Roar, utilize it. So get a button in there so you're like, you're just kind of taking hits, and then as you're taking hits, you can just release it and deal like a big pushback and a massive amount of damage, but you gotta have some kind of a counterplay for the player to have on that. So maybe being in that form for too long, you're taking damage, so you still take the damage, but the more damage you take during that time, you're able to do a bigger pushback, which can lead to you recovering better. So you still have to balance it out, because you can only take so much damage still, you know? I think that'd be a good defensive move. It's not burrito yet. No, it's not burrito yet, but I could use a burrito. All right. Well, I think we got a few good names here. I'm going to pick my own personal favorite, but I assure you each one of them will be sent to BP Outlaws over here. But I think that my favorite game in this, or my favorite name in this entire thing, I'm going to have to go with Dragon Dining, because it's as cute of a name as the game looks like. And it really fits the concept of what you're doing. You're just going around and eating dudes. So, Freddier, congratulations. I am going to send you a key for Skyhook. Thank you so much for the idea. I'm not saying he's going to go with it, but I am saying I loved it. Good call, man. There is your key, sir. Congratulations. And that's all that we had for the show tonight, folks. Thank you so much for coming out. I'm going to go ahead and push you guys over to somebody else. I believe that the lovely Nier is streaming right now. Might be working a little more on 3D art stuff, so that'll be fun. Let's go ahead and take a look and see who's streaming what. Don't forget to follow me on all the social platforms to find out what's going on in life. If you want to get in touch with my community, if you want to be a part of my community, I highly recommend you check out my Discord, where a bunch of developers will get together and give feedback on their games and all that fun stuff. And in addition, if you want to know when I go live immediately, go check out my Steam group. Right on Steam, you'll be getting a notification on Steam whenever I go live. It's a really good way to know when things are happening. But yeah, I'm going to throw you guys over to Nier, who is currently streaming work on, I want to say, her Kerrigan Cthulhu skin. So go check that out. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for coming out. I love you all so much. I hope to see you all tomorrow when I continue programming my game on right here on Twitch in Unity. So come on by and we'll see you all then. Take care, everybody. I'll see you next time.